Hey, what's up? People Piz out here, and today I want to talk to you guys about Dr. Sleep. And of course, Dr. Sleep is the sequel to The Shining, one of the most iconic, one of the most dissected, one of the most well-respected movies the horror genre has to offer. And as Dick Halloran told a young Danny Torrance in the Overlook Hotel while describing to him what it meant to shine, there are others out there. In the case of Dr. Sleep, those others consist of a group of nomadic shine suckers led by the enigmatic Rose the Hat, who track down, torture, and feed off of others who shine. And their next target is a young lady named Abra, whose ability to shine has got their mouths watering. Now it's up to an adult Danny Torrance to act as her mentor and protector. And right off the bat, I have to give huge props to the writer, producer, director, and editor of Dr. Sleep, Mike Flanagan, because he was given a seemingly insurmountable task with this film. With Dr. Sleep, Mike Flanagan has to appease fans of the Stephen King novel, The Shining, the Stanley Kubrick film, The Shining, and the Stephen King novel, Dr. Sleep. And he does an excellent job here. He walks such a fine line in this movie. He has to walk such a fine line in this movie in order to pay tribute to really all three of those things. And again, I think he does an excellent job. Now, I've been a big fan of Mike Flanagan ever since I saw the film Absentia, which if you haven't seen Absentia, go check it out. It's a great, great movie. And I've liked pretty much everything he's done since. But in the case of Dr. Sleep, this film truly shows what a capable and gifted filmmaker he is. And one of the things I loved so much about Dr. Sleep was Danny Torrance's, and I don't want to call it a character arc, I'm going to call it a character evolution, from the little boy in the wake of what happened at the Overlook Hotel to following in his father's footsteps and becoming a violent alcoholic as an adult to getting clean and eventually getting work as an orderly in a hospice. And this evolution produces so many great, great moments in this film, particularly moments that involve Danny comforting the ailing patients at the hospice. There's just some great emotional moments that happen therein. And there are these very quiet, very heartfelt, just two characters talking about life and death and what happens after death. And just exceptionally well-written, well-acted, just great, great moments in this film. Ewan McGregor is fantastic as Danny Torrance in Dr. Sleep. He imbues the character with this sense of collateral damage from his past, and at the same time, a grim understanding of how powerful and how self-destructive he can be, and how the two often go hand in hand. Rebecca Ferguson is also fantastic as Rose the Hat. Although she's the villain of the piece, her character is not just the typical antagonist. Her character is given some emotional depth that humanizes her. And even though we see her perform some truly evil acts in the movie, we understand why she's performing these truly evil acts. And I can totally understand why we'll likely see a lot of Rose the Hat cosplayers during next year's Halloween. Rebecca Ferguson's performance is sensual and sinister at the same time. When she's on screen, you cannot take your eyes off of her, and she looks great in that weird hat. Newcomer Kylie Curran almost steals the show here as Abra, the little girl with the enormous powers. Just a great performance from her. All of the supporting actors in the film deliver excellent performances as well. I was also really happy to see Alex Esso from Starry Eyes have a role in this film. I won't tell you which role, but I don't think it'll be too difficult to decipher if you think about it. There are moments in the first two acts of Dr. Sleep that just span the emotional gamut and show just how good a filmmaker Mike Flanagan is. Yes, there is fan service, but it's not the heavy-handed kind of fan service that we see so often in other movies, in which they're trying to cover up flaws in the film or mask the creative deficiencies in the filmmakers. This is good quality storytelling from a filmmaker who isn't afraid to make his audience cry 1 minute and cringe uncontrollably the next. Now, the third act of Dr. Sleep is a little problematic for me, although I was eagerly anticipating Danny's return to the Overlook Hotel. Once he gets there, I found myself more invested in the setting itself than the events transpiring there. This is where the movie kind of lost steam for me, and where the fan service began to feel like just bad cosplay. There is a sequence between Danny and a character from his past who shall remain nameless that I thought was incredibly compelling, but ultimately a missed opportunity. The final showdown between Danny and Rose the Hat just kind of felt unsatisfying, and the ending of the film was just honestly too schmaltzy for me. In a recent interview, Stephen King, whose dislike for Stanley Kubrick's The Shining is widely known, said that Dr. Sleep redeems Stanley Kubrick's The Shining. A, Stanley Kubrick's The Shining doesn't need to be redeemed. And if he's referring to Danny Torrance's fate in Dr. Sleep reflecting Jack Torrance's fate in his novel, The Shining, I don't call that redemption. I just call that plagiarism. Overall, I really liked Dr. Sleep. I thought it was an exceptionally well-made film with some great performances, compelling storytelling, and enough to make any Shining fan smile, whether you're a fan of the book or a fan of Stanley Kubrick's film. If you haven't seen the movie, go and watch it. Don't let the 2.5 hour runtime deter you. Trust me, this movie does not feel like a 2.5 hour movie at all. If you've seen Dr. Sleep, please let me know your thoughts on it down in the comment section below. Let me know how Dr. Sleep stacks up against Stanley Kubrick's The Shining, in your opinion, down in the comments section below. I'll also post a link to my review of The Shining that I posted a few days ago down in the description. Go over and check that out. If you like that video, please leave it a thumbs up and share it on social media. If you're not following me on social media, those links are in the description. They're also right around here. As always, thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Take care, and until next time, peace. Join the A Buck a Month Club and help support my channel on Patreon. Thank you to my current patrons, Kevin Smythe, B-Movie Mike, Robert Sobel, Turi Delamore, Stephen Flanagan, Lori Holt, Craig Farrand, Farron Sutton, Jeremiah Lambert, Grindhouse Grotto, Derek Janna, Demon Waffles, Simon Clark, Stone Gasman, Zachary Barton, Lauren Dixon, James Welch, Eli Geisler, Jeff Overing, Pete Toll, Kyle McGuire, Jay the Stingray, Andrew McDonald, Dave Barnes, Jonathan Lundy, Chris Gonzalez, R-Rated Horror, Fear Fuel, Jason Breitenbach, Brandon Bizdick, Steak Sauce, OG Myers, Mark Striano, Jeff Gardner, Travis Davis, The Obsolescionist, Chris Earls, Kevin Fitzpatrick, Randall Beatty, Joseph Hinkle, Hey Isn't That Devon Graham, and Christian Hanna Horror. Say hello to the internet, Jeremy.
Hello to the internet.